here, buddy. Another year's gone, come and gone, man. And we're not even 3 minutes from the truck, and we've already called in a spike. I hope that's the kind of weekend that we're into right now.
We're gonna have some fun.
Yeah.
Can't believe it's been a year.
Oh, man, time flies.
It's going real fast.
Time flies. I tell you, these busy lifestyles that we live, you know, and, you know, working with kids and you working out all the time, it's incredible, you know. But
fortunate to have the time to even do this. So.
Yep, that's right.
And take advantage of it.
Lucky enough to draw another tag, buddy, man, I tell you.
People call me lucky, I just call it hard work.
Hard work, that's right. Hey, when it comes together, you know, I'll guarantee you we're in for a great hunt. We have a day and this two days and this evening to get it done. And what's going to produce elk is going to be putting the miles. And that's one thing I really like about hunting with you is you are in shape and you push us, man. You're 10 times better in shape than we are. But
well, I hope you can keep up.
All right, let's go get them. What's going on up there? I know he bugled.
The wind was just wrong. He cut. The wind cut off and it was calling it. We talked about it earlier. The wind was just a little bit wrong, but he came down and he was all. He wanted something. He wanted a piece. He wanted to find out what was going on down there. But yeah, the horns. He started rattling the horns like that. He just got him perked up. What is that?
Yeah.
Coming on now. So he was a little small, clubbed on one side.
All right. Cool. You weren't going to shoot him?
No, he was pretty small.
Okay, good.
Let him live for another year.
I tell you what, this really works good. This is what I was doing. Watch. I was kneeling. And you don't do that. And I just tinker the horns a little bit. No, nothing big, nothing major. Nothing major, just enough to get their curiosity going. But keep rubbing that horn, and while you're doing that, you can throw them some. And then. Man, I love this stuff, man. I'm glad you. Hey, you could have shot him, though.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. awesome. That's two bulls today.
Small round. All right.
I know. We're going to get to the big ones. Just give me... That's another 3 or 4 miles, dude. Let's go.
That one was beautiful.
Yeah, there was another one beautiful. This is what works. I know they weren't big bulls or anything, but man, talk about excitement. It's 10-11, and you know the thing about it is it's early elk season, September, and you just got to produce a lot of elk talk, elk action, the horns. People, let me tell you something. If you're not hunting with horns, you're not hunting elk the right way. I'll tell you that right now. Bugling, you know, trying to simulate two bulls bugling back and forth, it creates, you know, a lot of interest in these elk, curiosity, and man, I tell you what, there's nothing like elk hunting out here. I hope you enjoyed that tip. It works, and it works on big bulls too. We'll be right back with some more action.
on, Bill.
That's how you get it done. Holy cow, what a hard hunt.
Yeah, man. What about that, buddy?
Dude.
What about that?
You, know, you were back here, we snuck up a little bit, and you started rattling these horns. He, all of a sudden, it was instant. Instant. He came down, hauling, hauling.
Yeah.
I couldn't believe it.
I tell you what, man.
He wants to get up.
I tell you what, people, if you're hunting without the horns, you're not hunting at all. It's like hunting without a bugle tube, and you need the combination of them all. Todd, awesome hunt, man. Good shot.
Ralph, thanks.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Heart shot.
Yeah. That was awesome, man.
Dude, that thing just plugged, right? Perfect. Yeah. I had a window. You're trying to stop him. You stopped him just in the only window that I had.
Wow. Hey, like I talk about it in the seminars, we always say, the early bird gets the elk. Talk about walking in an hour in dark. Yeah. You know, an hour in the dark, we got up there. Boy, we called in that one bull right away. He was just a little dink. Called in a second bull. He was on top of you like that.
Yep.
What happened with that one?
Well, the second one came up and Jay was like, we got to get up on top. And I'm like, okay. And you started calling and I didn't even have an arrow ready. And he came hauling all up over the top within 10 yards of us and I couldn't do anything.
Wow.
Couldn't do anything. But
hey, what about the last setup, man? Using the X Zone, you set up. What happened there? The bull was coming right from the bottom straight up.
I made the mistake of setting up behind a tree. And so when he came up and went left, I had no shot and he was perfectly broadside. The best thing for you know, just like Jay, just like you say, set up in front of that tree.
In front.
Get in that front of the tree. Then you have nothing. You have all of the shooting lane. Well, that's what camo's for.
Exactly. That mossy oak camo, you know, that's why I always say you got to set up in front of that tree. Be ready. You know, and the thing about it is play that wind. If the wind's going in this direction and you're right here and he's coming up, he's not going to come straight up. He's going to try to get that wind and circle and roundhouse us on that. And that's when you're ready, buddy. But you know what?
Hey, Ralph, that's two for two.
Two for two,
dude,
baby.
If you guys ever want to come to New Mexico and hunt elk like this, this little crazy guy right here with these horns and calls and everything, that's the ticket.
Oh, man.
Dude, he's got little kickers on top.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, he's got little kickers.
Yeah,
I think
he does.
He's going to be an 8x6.
All right, man. Congratulations, Todd. Let's go get him.
Hey, for all you viewers at home, if you have never had the opportunity to hunt in a way like this, I encourage you guys to get out and do it. Like Ralph was saying, get some rattling horns. Get a bunch of calls. I mean, look at this. He's got calls. He's got calf call, another call, horns, bugle,
yep.
Two bugles. If you have the opportunity to do that and get those calls, practice with them, and it makes a difference. It makes a huge difference. You never know what they're gonna react to. You could have one call all day and be like, I don't understand. The next day, change to a different call, like that.
That's right. Absolutely, man. So, I tell you what. Congratulations, buddy. I am pumped up.
Hey, is this gonna be on the 51? The hot 51.
That's right. The hot 50 memories. Absolutely. Hey, man. I hope you enjoyed that awesome action. We'll be right back with some more kills. Yeah, baby. Congratulations there, buddy. What do you think of that action?
That is some action, Ralph.
Oh, man.
I mean, the horns, the scenery, everything. It's
gone, man. It's just awesome. I mean, hunting them on the ground, you know, you're just moving in, running, gunning. Man, I'll tell you what, it's incredible, man. I love this rattling, this early season rattling. When you've got the bulls talking a little bit, just giving up their location. You move in there, curiosity, man. This is what puts it to them, man.
You know what else put it to them? A PSE of mine.
You bet. That PSC bow just drilled him.
I mean, smacked him hard, and he just didn't even know what happened.
What do you think of this hunting in New Mexico?
Hey, New Mexico, they got it going on. Maybe, wait a minute. I think if you come to Colorado, then Colorado's then got it going on.
All right.
You have a lot to do with it, Ralph. Thanks.
Hey, you're welcome,
Appreciate
buddy. I hope you enjoyed this other awesome hunt out here in my home state of New Mexico. We'll be right back with some more action. Yeah. Hey man, again, welcome to All the Right Moves. Here's the hunting tip about deboning and field carrying for your animal. What I'm gonna go ahead and do right now is show you the cuts that you've gotta do right away when you're gonna bone out an animal. Notice that my elk right now is laying on its side. And the very first thing I like to do is to make all your skin cuts. Notice it's skinned all the way from the rear. You're gonna go right along the spine all the way to the neck into the antlers up here in the front where you're gonna do your Y cut, okay? Now, if you back up a little bit, I like to give my taxidermist a little bit more hide. So right about mid-body, I like to just go all the way around the animal, okay? All the way around. Once I get to this front leg, I like to make a little incision over here in the front. And I'll just come right on the bottom of that elbow, down to the bottom of the brisket area, back to this long old cut. Now, here's another tip that I think is very important. I like to come back here from the very top, right down the hind quarter, all the way down to the hock. And the reason why I like to do this is because I like to fold, once I start to skinning, which you're gonna see the next step, when you start folding this in the back in the hind quarter, you can actually bone that meat all the way around and that you're not fighting that hide all the time. But let me go ahead and get started with step number two, and we'll start skinning this animal out for you. I'm done. If you can notice, the whole animal is skinned out. And the nice thing that I like to do is I like to use this outdoor edge swing blade. I really like it. I like the main blade for skinning, but I like to use also the swing blade for all the different cuts that I showed you on step one. All right, man, we're now ready for the deboning to begin. Like I said earlier, I like to go up the hind quarter with the skin, get the skin all the way around, the animal skinned out, and it'll make it a lot easier to start quartering out the meat. Well, let me get started. I like to feel for these sections of muscles. You know, number one is, these muscles, you know, they go all the way up to that bone. You can see right here, you know, it's just a bunch of sectional cuts. You know, here's your lower round, you know, and you just keep cutting away on that section. Keep going. Get a nice piece of meat going here. All the way down to his tailbone. And right here's his hip bone right here. Right here, you can feel that muscle. So I'm gonna just go right on in and cut right up to that hip. I'm gonna go ahead and make me a little notch. What I mean a notch here is a little holder. I'm gonna go ahead and poke me a hole in the meat, grab it with both of my hands. Now I can control that meat down to the bone. That's what I'm cutting right now. And just keep working that knife. The key thing is cut towards the bone, not into the meat. But there's already one nice chunk of meat. Now, the thing that I recommend is some big old plastic bags like this. What's gonna happen is we're gonna put all our meat in here, goes directly into the backpack, and from there, the packing begins. So let me continue on cutting some more meat here. And here's another awesome piece of meat right here. Again, right into the plastic bag. Now, what we wanna go ahead and do is come over to the bottom round and try to cut all this stuff off as well. But like I said, you know, just try to work the bone, you know. You know, when you cut into the meats where you're gonna really ruin a lot of the choice cuts. So what you wanna do is work that bone. See that bone right there? You know, you wanna cut in to the bone. Here's the meat, here's the bone, and here we go. We're gonna go right around this end, and here we go. Hey, look at that. Look at that awesome piece of meat right there. Boy, that's incredible. This is gonna be some good, tasty meat right here. All right, thank you, Todd. Let's go ahead and just cut me another hook here.
It's a two-person job.
Yeah, I tell you what, it's always easier when you do have a second hand. Let me make you a handle there. There you go.
Got it?
I got it. Thank you. Here we go. Right there, look at that chunk. It's coming right off. There's your hind quarter. One thing that I recommend is that you want to put your hind quarter and the back strap into one bag, and then we'll put that into a backpack and we're good to go. Now let's work that, let's go ahead and work the back straps, man. Fine piece of meat. Check this out. Very choice grade of meat here. But anyways, what we want to do is we want to start from the hip bone. You can feel that hip bone right there. Of course, we cut that hind quarter on this side. Now you're on this other side of that hip bone working this back strap. And what you want to do is you just want to keep cutting, you know, keep cutting. Then you just work the bone. And what happens is when you get up here in the front, you just keep working it, you know, and again, don't cut in towards the meat. Work that bone. Let that bone guide you. That's a key thing to do here. Notice that back strap, we're now getting into the neck, and we continue working that neck, same way. You know, just keep cutting that piece of meat. Look at that long piece of meat right there. That's what I'm talking about, you know. You throw that whole piece of meat into this backpack, and I'll tell you what, you keep everything nice and clean. Whoa, that's heavy. That's choice meat right there, man. This is exciting. That's what elk hunting's all about. We'll be right back. We're going to show you how to take the shoulder off now. You can feel that solid bone right there. It runs, it's a pretty long bone. What you want to start doing is cut again into that bone. Just follow that bone and just keep going all the way to this joint, this shoulder joint, down to this other forearm, and just keep cutting into it. Now you want to just start trimming that back, you know, just keep working that shoulder blade. And here's on the other side as well, you know. And what an awesome piece of meat right here. You gotta go ahead and keep cutting into that bone. Here we go. Here's what you call an awesome shoulder roast. Awesome piece of meat right here. You know, I like to start out here on top, working that. Again, working that
shoulder bone. You just keep, just like if you're skinning out that meat, you know, see how that comes? Real easy. You know, here we go. Now we're gonna be really careful with this bull because he was actually shot right through the heart. Todd did a super job with that placement of the arrow. And we're gonna be careful because I know that broadhead's still in there. So we're gonna just take this piece of the shoulder. Choice meat again, buddy. That's exciting. Let's continue on. Let's get underneath this shoulder and see what else is going on.